Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how to use Zoom and how to host a meeting on Zoom on your desktop if you're a Mac user or you're a Windows user. So the first thing you need to do is you need to create an account. If you don't have an account already, you have to sign up with Zoom or Zoom here, or you can sign in with your Gmail or with Facebook account. And you need to do this to be able to host a meeting or to join a meeting on the Zoom platform. So once you have created your account already, or you have an existing account, you can click sign in here, or you can simply go, like I told you, you can simply log in here with your Gmail or your Facebook. So I'm going to log in my Gmail now. And once you select your Gmail account you want to log in with, you'll be brought to this page here. And the next thing you need to do to host a meeting on Zoom is to click host a meeting. So here you can see you have three options. You can either host a meeting with your video turned off, or you can host a video with a meeting with your video turned on, or you can decide to only share your screen. So I'm going to host a meeting with my video turned off. So I click on this, and right here you'll be brought to this page here. If you don't have the Zoom desktop application, the next thing you need to do is to click on download now. So you can download the Zoom desktop client or application on your desktop to use the Zoom application. So once this is done downloading, you will get a pop-up at the bottom left corner of the page here. So all you need to do is just to click on this, and it installs Zoom on your computer. So once you have Zoom downloaded and you have installed Zoom on your computer, the next thing you need to do is to go to the desktop application or the icon, sorry, and double click on this to open the Zoom interface on your desktop. Then you'll be brought to a page like this, and you can see you have different options here. You can create a new meeting, you can decide to join a meeting, you can decide to schedule a meeting for a particular period of time, you can also share your screen as well. So today we'll be focusing on creating a meeting. Also, just underneath new meeting, you can see we have this arrow here at the bottom. If I should click on this, you can see we have start with video. This means that if you don't want your video to be connected or to display your video during the meeting, all you need to do is to just uncheck this. And you can see we have this cross over the video. Means that once you start the meeting, your video is not going to display. So I'm going to use it right now. So once you're done doing that, or you decide to show your video, the next thing you need to do is to click on new meeting. Yes, and then you'll be brought up with these options menu here to join with your computer audio, whatever computer audio you have connected to your computer. So yeah, I just click on this. If you want to test your mic, you can do this with your microphone, but I'm just going to click join with computer audio. And once you have done that and you are the meeting has been created, you can see that we have these options or different icons at the bottom of the page. So from the left here we have mute. If I should click on this, then I have been muted and people in the meeting can't hear what I'm saying. But if I want them to hear what I'm saying, I click on this again and I have then been unmuted. Beside this we have this arrow here. If I should click on the arrow, you can see we have select a microphone, we have select a speaker. So these two options simply shows you whatever connected device you have connected to your computer. So you can decide to pick whatever devices you have connected. You can decide to change whatever devices you want to use to talk, for example for the microphone or for the speaker to listen. So these are the options here. Just beside mute we have start video. If I should click on this now, my camera will be turned on and the people in the meeting can see me. But if I don't want it once it's on, you leave it like this and make sure it's crossed. Then beside start video, the arrow here shows you the different devices connected to your computer that you can use to display your video if you want to. So just beside that we have participants, or after security we have participants. This helps you manage the interactions or the the behaviors of the people you have in the meeting. So if I should click on this now, you can see here, if I should go to a particular, the name of a particular person, I can decide to mute the person or unmute the person. I also have these options here, Shane Moore. If I should click on this, I can change my profile picture or rename, change the existing name that is displaying during the meeting. So at the bottom of this, you can see we have invites, we have mute all, and we have more options here. So if I should click on invites, this helps you to invite people to join the meeting. For example, now if you have already created a contact on Zoom, you have a contact field, you can select this and send them like an invitation. That's the people you have on your contact. Or you can send people emails or bulk emails by clicking on this here on the email tab. And you can see you can either use a default email, you can use Gmail, or you can use Yahoo Mail. Or simply you can copy the invitation link, or you can copy invitation, or you can also copy the invitation link and copy the meeting password, you understand? But to make it easy for you, if you want to send it through Gmail, you can send it directly. Or if you want to copy the invitation, you can copy the invitation here by clicking on this, and it tells you that the invitation has been copied to your clipboard. So if you should go to a notepad, for example this one, and if I should click paste, you can see that it has auto-generated the invitation link for me, and also a password. So it's easy, so you can copy this and send it directly to whoever person you want to invite to the meeting. I'll just click and minimize this. So this is how you can send invitations to people to join the meeting. Next to invite, we have mute all. This helps you to mute every single person in the meeting. Everybody in the meeting will be muted. Or if you don't want to mute everybody, then you can leave that option on. And next to this, we have the more option. If I should click on the more option, you can see we have some various options to pick from here. But one of the most important one here is to mute participants upon entry. This means that before they come into the meeting, they are muted, just in case somebody forgets to turn off his microphone and he forgets and there are some particular noises coming from the person. This enables the mics to already be muted before the person joins the meeting. So next, participants, we have chats. So here, this helps you manage how the chat interaction is being done during the Zoom meeting. You can decide to send a message to everyone, or if we have other people now selected in the meeting, some other names here will pop up. So you can decide to send a message to everyone, or you can decide how you send the messages to either individuals or a particular person. Then next to this here, we have the option here that says more. If I should click on this, you can decide to set how the participants interact with each other. You can decide to set that they do not chat or do not send messages with each other. You can decide to get the messages only by yourself. You can make them chat publicly but not privately. But if you want them to chat both privately and publicly, you can select this option here. So next to chat, we have screen share, meaning you can decide to share your screen if you'd want to. And next to screen share, we have record. This helps you to record the meeting in an MP4 format. And once the meeting is done, it would save the file and send you a pop-up immediately the meeting is done, so you can see the meeting in the video for yourself. So next to record, we have reactions. So this helps you to react to a particular comment or to a particular thing somebody saying. So you can click on this. If I should give a clap now, you can see at the top left corner of the page, you can see it displays here as well. So once the meeting is done, if you want to end the meeting, just click on this here. And you can see you have two different options. You can decide to end the meeting for everybody. You can also decide to leave the meeting. Leaving the meeting means that the meeting will still go on while you have left the meeting. Or you can decide to end the meeting for all. So I'll click on this here. And you can see the meeting has ended and you'll be brought back to the desktop Zoom application. If you were recording the screen, the saved file will pop up here and you can see the video and you can also look at it for yourself. And also, you can see we have the home, we have chat here to send messages to individual people. You have the meeting here, that is your meeting information. And also you have contact here as well. Contact helps you to, you can create contacts here so that send message can be easy. That's if you use Zoom regularly or a lot. Or you can also select channels to create a channel with contacts in them as well. So If you know you don't use Zoom very often to host meetings, then just using the in video message sending like I showed you, it's a good option, and it's okay for you to use as well. So you can see Zoom is a very powerful software. You can use it to teach people, to hold classrooms, to hold meetings, to work from home, to create virtual meetings, to chat with people, conference calls, to share your screen. So it's a very powerful tool that's helped people do a lot of things. So guys, if you have any question, leave them in the description below. I hope to see you next time, and I hope this video was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.